room at the M's, don't even comb my hair. The bitches smell the money when I walk in, they noses flare. Came from the bottom, shit, I barely had clothes to wear. So give me my roses while I'm here, bitch, it's only fair. You know how niggas rockin' over here. Lil bro just caught his eighth body before he made it to his Kobe year. That nigga caught eight bodies before he made it to his Kobe year. Kobe here and everybody masked up. It took six niggas 6 hours just to bag up. Hold my glass up, sipping Krug in a Maybach truck. A real boss gon' make sure all his peoples got they bag up. You talk the hardest niggas out, my name get definitely brought up. But it's deeper than rap, take my rats, investing in startups. When you rich and you black, you become a threat when you smart enough. My nigga died while writing this verse like my heart ain't dark enough. Made my heart harden up. Draco put them niggas on spin cycle, we wash them up. My wrist cost a buck, them brakes bought from us. The big dog, my pups, got switch on them Glock, they lip off and bust. They say imitation a form of flattery. Machine get on a beat, it's insulting battery. They're getting so much money, my old bitches is mad at me. From how I put my new bitch in gallery, change the salary.
Poppin' ecstasy, Addy, cause I wasn't tryna sleep. Where I come from at average was all savagery. Now the mansions is lavish, I want a half a B. Circumstances was bad and my bitch as bad as me. Bro died for an 8-ball, he worked for half a key. His mama still live on the Ave, I still ride past the C. How she doing? In my hood I got influence. Murder one, I drunk a 4 and took a Xan and made me crash the V. Niggas talk about I'm greedy, I was the last to eat. Black gloves and ski masks, that used to last a week. A week straight, heart was filled with grief and hate. Shit, I been through lawyer, won 100K, that's a cheap case. Took a loss and missed the show, they want another date. My mom's tripping about the rent, she like 2 months late. I got right back in them trenches, what you mean? This a never-ending cycle, my landlord was a fiend, nigga. Get out the way when I see red, cause you green, nigga. Game 7, I was locked in with my team, nigga. Play my position, crunch time, I was great at that. Spray that goddamn lay back and made back, I got a rate at that. Heard a faker, a creative player, never heard of that. Now I'm major, but I still a lay down for that murder rap. Was exhausted, missed a couple bosses, ain't deserved a nap. All we know is fact, and get that murder back. But I'm calm now, hit my knees and start praying with my palms out. I'm a leader and they want me to be strong now. Reaching for the skies, I can't put my arms down. Glizzy in my left hand, can't put my arm down. God with me cause I'm alive, devil on my side. Daydreaming while I drive, got me in a trance. Since my brain got advanced, I can't trust my friends. I kill my man.
Alright, fellas, meal number 2. I guess it's not a fucking meal, but it's a smoothie.
We got like some assorted fruits in there. We got some protein powder, scoop of vanilla protein. I don't fuck with the chocolate. And then I put some fucking milk in there. So that's the second meal of the day. First meal I had like some Greek yogurt and shit, but yep. That's what we're doing. Yeah, I'm at maintenance calories this week because it's a deload. So there's no point in eating in a deficit because I'm trying to recover my body. So yeah, just eat at a maintenance. There's no point in eating at a surplus either because, you know, I'm not putting on any muscle this week because I'm in a fucking deload. So yeah, I got this fucking smoothie. Usually what I would put in here would be like some peanut butter or some shit just to get the calories up. But obviously I'm not doing that shit now, you know. I ate way too much peanut butter and that shit is honestly not that good for you, but it's definitely helpful if you're bulking. But now that I'm not bulking, you know, I gotta be cutting that shit out. The goal at the start of the cut should be not to decrease the amount of food you eat, but to eat like the same quantities, but just eat less of the fucking calorie dense foods. So yeah, that's kind of what I'm doing, just in the maintenance this week, and then I'm gonna start cutting the calories down next week.
All right, so I just got done filming this YouTube video.
You know, we got this set up right here. I don't know if you can see that tripod.
Yep.
We got some motivation.
So let me know what you guys are thinking about those motivational videos, or just let me know what you think about my content in general. Let me know what you want to see, because I don't know what you guys want to see. Sometimes one type of video does well, sometimes that same type of video does like shit 5 times in a row. So let me know. Let me know if you want to see the workouts, if you want to see the vlogs, if you want to see more informational stuff, if you want to see the motivational stuff, if you want to see me, I don't know, harassing people, taking shits in public, let me know that too.
But yeah, decided to take a little walk in the park. So
you gotta break up.
I gotta break up like the day in some way. I usually take a walk in the morning, but I'm taking this walk in the middle of the day. You gotta break up the day. Like for me, like to regain my focus, I gotta break up the day, take a walk or some shit, and just like avoid stimulation, because I'm stimulating myself all day. You know, trying to post 2 YouTube videos, trying to post 2 to 3 or 2 to 4 reels, and just doing all that shit. Like, I gotta be on social media a lot, and if I'm not conscious of it, really fucking makes me stress, really like fucks up my head. So I gotta do shit like this, like no podcast, no fucking music, no nothing, just, you know, me and my fucking thoughts. But yeah, fucking, I don't know. I put that YouTube video up, and it's just kind of some motivational shit. I don't know. This shit is weird, though. Like, I'm really going all out on the fucking content creation. I'm really going all out on the YouTube and everything. And it's not like I've made it to the point where I'm even monetized yet. But I'm just going all in on it because I see the vision. I can see I'm going to make it work. And I'm gonna make it work. You know? You can make it work too. You can be anything. You can be whatever the fuck you wanna be. I never thought I would be fucking creating YouTube videos for a living, but it looks like that's what's gonna be it. You know, this shit is crazy. I didn't think I was gonna be this shit. I thought I was gonna be working at a desk job, working some blue collar shit. But you could be anything that you fucking put your mind to. You just gotta say fuck other people's judgment. That's really why you're not where you wanna be, because other people's judgment. You're afraid that other people are gonna judge you for what you do. Fuck them. You could be whatever the fuck you wanna be. You just gotta be not afraid of other people's judgment. I don't give a fuck what you've done. You can be whatever the fuck you want to be. You can reinvent yourself. I don't give a fuck what you went through. I don't give a fuck what you did. I don't give a fuck if you killed somebody, you sold some drugs. You can reinvent yourself. Look at some of our favorite artists. They're doing the same shit. But yeah, I'm just here to fucking, I don't know, I'm just here to fucking document the whole process day to day, show you guys what it looks like, show you guys how to get it done yourselves, both in the gym and, you know, in life, how to get to where you want to be. But you know, the one thing is, you can't be afraid of other people's judgment. You might have to do some shit you're uncomfortable with. I'm not comfortable making fucking vlogs. I'm not a fucking vlog guy by heart. You know, I don't got that type of personality. But, you know, here I am making a fucking vlog. I never thought I'd say I'm making a fucking vlog. But, you know, here I am. So.
All right, we got the next meal. We got some fucking Yep, some pasta, ground beef.
I don't really want to eat this shit right now, to be honest. Like, it doesn't feel right eating fucking, like, pasta at, like, 4 in the fucking afternoon. But, like, this is all I have made, so, you know, you gotta make do with what you got. And this is moderately healthy. But, yeah, I'm gonna, like, cook some salmon or some shit for dinner. So, we'll see how that goes.
All right, fellas. We got some fish. We got some fucking salmon. Straight out the freezer. Straight out the Atlantic freezer. Straight from Aldi. I don't buy any of the fresh stuff. I only buy the cheap stuff, all right? So what I'm doing, I'm gonna show you a salmon recipe that is basically like a good fucking salmon recipe. So it's like, like soy ginger salmon. This is like the only salmon recipe I know. I used to make salmon all the time when I was all fucked up. And I would just follow the same recipe because I'd always get lazy. So first thing you want about, I don't know, 2-3 tablespoons of soy sauce. I'm just gonna start pouring it. I like to use the reduced sodium stuff because even this has a shit ton of fucking sodium. And you know, sodium's not necessarily bad, especially if you work out a lot, but I feel like this is kind of excessive, especially for the amounts I'm using. So there, we got that in there. And then also I'm not even working out this week really, so like I don't really need this salt. Salt is more so for the pumps and shit and for sweat. Red wine vinegar. So you're gonna want to use about, I don't know, 2 tablespoons of that. And as you can tell, we ran out here. So we're gonna grab another one. Oh, cool. Can you see me in this bitch? All right. Get some more red wine vinegar. Bada boom, bada bing. The next ingredient is going to be some extra virgin olive oil. Same thing, about 1.5 tablespoons, 2 tablespoons, I don't know. Just, this part is important because I'm gonna bake the salmon. I usually like to grill it, but I don't have a fucking grill here. So I'm gonna bake it and I want it to be like crispy. So matter of fact, I'm gonna add some more olive oil into that. That's probably too much, but. Oh shit. Garlic powder, and I'm almost out of this shit, fuck. But I got enough for today. So garlic powder, you know, a little bit of that. You know, I just measure from the salt. I don't fucking measure the spices. Some red pepper. Pour that generously. This salmon is kind of cheap, low quality, so you can never go wrong. Some red pepper to fucking wash down the flavor and rubberness. This shitty quality salmon. Garlic, I don't like to use, like, I don't like to chop up fresh garlic because I'm fucking lazy. So I like to use some of this stir-in paste. Maybe a teaspoon. Tablespoon, something like that. Boom. Some stir-in ginger. You know, obviously you could use some fresh ginger if you're a fucking hippie. About the same amount, you know, teaspoon, tablespoon, tomato. And good. The final ingredient is going to be some all natural, straight from the bee's titty. Honey. Yeah, about 1.5 tablespoons of that, I don't know. Yep, and we are in business. So now what you're gonna do is stir this all up, right? You stir it all up. Stir it all up. All right, we got that. All right, it looks like it's good. Hopefully I'm not spilling shit. And then what we're gonna do is add some fucking pepper to the salmon. There we go. Add a dash of some pink salt. Prefer to use the pink salt over the regular salt. It's a little bit better for you.
And I think that should be it. And then now you pour this bitch over here. Boom. You let the fish take a bath. Kind of mix these up a little bit, you know. Let that sit for, I don't know, maybe 30 minutes. And then we are gonna throw this salmon in the fucking oven. All right, I'm about to stretch out. My fucking neck and my traps are so motherfucking sore right now. Like, this is my workspace, you know. I got the couch and I got this low ass coffee table. So I'm gonna be hunched over like a fucking gremlin all day. So I definitely gotta stretch this shit out. So check out my very special stretching routine.
Alright guys, so here's my fucking stretching routine. I believe you gotta have some sort of stretching routine daily. You gotta be doing stretches every single day. And my recommendation to you would be do the same stretches so you know that you know what's working and what isn't. Just like your workouts, you wanna kinda track your stretching and be consistent with it. And I believe you should be doing this type of stuff every single day, 2 to 3 times a day. Get those areas where that are gonna get really tight from sitting. Your hips, your upper back, your spine, your lower back. That's what you see me doing here. A lot of rotational stuff, some hip flexor stretching, some thoracic stretching. This shit pays dividends over time.
I know this shit looks like ass. I put some hot sauce on it because it looked bland as fuck. But for some reason, that's what happens whenever you bake it. So you gotta grill this shit. But, you know, I don't have a fucking grill. So, yeah, I'm gonna eat these two bitches. I forgot I didn't have any rice. I usually pair this with some rice or, like, some potatoes. That's what I really wanted to do. But I didn't have that shit. So, I'm gonna eat this. I still got, like, 900 calories left today. It's, like, 8:30. So, after I eat this, I'm probably gonna head to the gas station. Yeah, head to the gas station and just buy some fucking random bullshit there. And then, that's pretty much it, man. I made a YouTube video up already today. This one will probably go up tonight, hopefully. Getting the wisdom teeth removed tomorrow. Do a vlog on that, hopefully. And then I had like 2 or 3 reels go up today. Probably gonna try and put up one or two more right before, I go to sleep. And that's pretty much the day. But yeah, I'm just trying to push out this content like a motherfucker. Like, I figured the more I could put out, the better. Like, it can't hurt, right? So as long as it's not garbage content and it's like halfway decent, you know, you never know what's gonna hit. So I just try and make it decent, try and help people, and I try and come from the place of actually trying to help people rather than just trying to focus on increasing my followers, increasing my dollars. And yeah, I just come from the mindset of trying to help people because that's really what keeps me going. If I just focus too much on the likes, the comments, all that, and how much engagement I'm getting and how many new clients I'm getting, then it's not gonna keep me going because there's gonna be bad days and there's gonna be good days. So I gotta focus on just putting out shit that might help one person. But yeah.